the point. John Keats was one of the main figures of the second generation of romantic poets. This poem is an excerpt from his poem Endymion. According to Greek mythology, Endymion, the shepherd beloved of the moon goddess Selene. Keats devoted his life to the perfection of a poetry marked by vivid imagery, great sensuous appeal, and an attempt to express a philosophy through classical legend. John Keats was born on 31st October 1795 and died on 23rd February 1821. He died at a very young age of 25.
A Thing of Beauty by John Keats. A thing of beauty is a joy forever. Its loveliness increases. It will never pass into nothingness. But still will keep a bower quiet for us, and a sleep full of sweet dreams, and health and quiet breathing. Therefore, on every morrow, are we wreathing a flowery band to bind us to the earth. Some shape of beauty moves away the pall from our dark spirits, such the sun, the moon, trees old and young, sprouting a shady boon for simple sheep, and such are daffodils with the green world they live in, and clear rills that for themselves a cooling covert make against the hot season, the mid-forest brake, rich with a sprinkling of fair musk rose blooms, an endless fountain of immortal drink pouring unto us from the heaven's brink.
The poet says that beauty stays forever. It never fades away. It increases with the passing time. Beauty is like a beautiful shady tree under whose shade all the creatures can sleep peacefully and enjoy good health. Every day it is a beauty which fills us with the spirit to live. The beauty builds the desire in us to live and bind us to the earth. It is a such as the sun, moon, trees, flowers, and rivers are like a blessing bestowed on all the creatures by the earth. They provide us with shade, fragrance, and coolness during the hot summer. They are a boon for us. Daffodils are beautiful with their green world spreading their fragrance. The clear stream cools a long hot summer. The thick green bushes of musk roses spreads fragrance. They are like nectar given by God to us. These things are the gifts from God for all of us. These are the beauties which are immortal and give us a reason to live on this earth, despite having so many sorrows in our life.